A 65-year-old female comes in complaining of discomfort in her left mid face. I take a cone beam CT, and this is what I see. What? The workup and treatment today on the Open Reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton, and today we're discussing a 65-year-old female who came in with left mid-face pain. This patient describes pain similar to chronic sinusitis, a constant pressure in her left sinus. She's also been referred for extraction of her remaining teeth in preparation for a denture. I take a cone beam CT, and this is what I see. Okay, clearly we have a problem here. There's a large foreign body floating in her left sinus. Now what is this thing and where did it come from? This is where it gets a little bad. This patient tells me that she had an implant placed a few years ago at an outside office. She was told that the implant didn't work and that they had to remove it. Well, they were right that it didn't work, but clearly removing it didn't happen. It stuck up in her sinus and she has no idea. In addition, you can see that the sinus is very cloudy in this area, suggesting a chronic infectious process. I discussed multiple treatment options with her, and she elected to undergo the procedure under IV sedation in the office. I'm going to make a lateral window into the sinus cavity and then remove this implant. If you haven't yet, check out my video on the channel about removing foreign bodies in the maxillary sinus. It's a great video that reviews how to go after other things in the maxillary sinus, like displaced tooth roots. However, in this case, there was no way to access it from the initial osteotomy because it's well healed over at this point. The only way to get this implant is to make a lateral window into the sinus and remove it from there. I administer local anesthesia, and then I'm going to make a full thickness mucoperiosteal flap with a distal vertical release. I'm going to extend this incision to the papilla of the adjacent teeth, since I'm going to be removing these teeth after I'm done with this anyway. Access is key here. I want to make sure that I'm able to retract the flap superiorly without fighting it so that I'm able to visualize the lateral maxilla. Now that I have the access I need, I'm going to make a lateral window. I'm going to make this window in the vicinity of where I know the sinus is and also where the implant is based off of the CT scan. I'm going to remove bone down to the cnidarian membrane. Here's the start of my lateral window, and I can see the membrane is intact. Next, I'm going to take a curette and perforate the sinus. If I was doing a sinus lift, the goal would be to maintain the integrity of this membrane. But since this implant is sitting in the middle of it, I have to violate it. As soon as I puncture the membrane, there's a large amount of pus. Here's the purulence pouring from the sinus, and there's a large amount of it. Clearly, this has been infected for a long time. There's a lot of granulation tissue here. I remove all inflammatory tissue while trying to preserve as much of the membrane as possible. After I've expressed as much purulence as possible, I irrigate it thoroughly and try to visualize the implant. I can now see it, and I'm going to use a hemostat to retrieve it. Here it is. Feels good to get that out of there. Now I'm going to irrigate the site very thoroughly. Now I'm going to lay my flap back down and obtain a primary closure using micro sutures. I placed this patient on antibiotics and decongestants and saw her back 2 weeks later. The site is healing great, and the pain and pressure she was feeling in her mid-face have gone away completely. Thanks so much for watching. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out my channel for other interesting OMFS cases just like this one. Also, keep an eye on my website, theopenreduction.com, where I'll be posting advanced surgical content to help you hone your oral surgery skills. I'm Dr. Tom Bolton. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.